up, guys? I'm back with another video. First mock ever built. I built it with my best friend, Gage. You should check out my brother's channel. It's called... I forgot what it was called. But, I'll tell you in the comments, I guess. I'll put a link. Okay. Sorry, I'm coughing. This is a mock of the Revolutionary War, American Revolutionary War. Sorry if you're British and you don't like this, people making mocks out of this, because, you were basically kind of the, you were a big enemy to the Americans. And probably didn't have, didn't really have a great reputation then, like as far as being good. But now let's get into this. Let's start off with the British. Actually, I'm gonna give you a little storyline. So the British have just won a battle. To get here, and you can see some rubble, and they're trying to get to this supply outpost being held by the Americans, so that they can stop American supplies from getting to where, to George Washington's camp and the American troops. They also have money there, so they don't want the Americans to be able to spend money. Now let's actually take a look at what this mock is like. Sorry, some of it is breaks a few times because this isn't the best place to put it. Like, base plates kind of bend, so that just makes it hard to put other base plates on it. But many figures are fine. So, right here, you'll notice these barracks or trench, and he's got a musket there. I don't have any pieces to make I forgot what they're called, but they're the weapons that have like spikes on the end. But it's hard to make British troops if you don't buy the buff of sources where they make custom figures. And you have to get a lot of red shirts. And I use a technique where you just put the legs backwards, and then if you sit him down, he actually looks like he's kneeling. Like that. That's a cool trick I learned. So, then, over here is a cannon. And, we ended up replacing the wheels. And there's a gunner. He's got a knife to set it off. You can see he's wearing some, like, more protective clothes. Because, he's a gunner. So, that's him. And then, over here, we'll find the general on his war horse. He's got a saddle, too. This is one of the older horses that my friend has. I'm just gonna set this down. And, you can see... He uses a lot of Captain Hook pieces, so, and I just, decided he lost his hand in battle, so he got up and he got a hook because he's important. That's the British side. Now we'll move over to the Americans. Actually, first, I'll just show you this other British guy battling an American. Well, they're all shooting and fighting the Americans. So, a really nice shot, I think. So, he's broken through the barricade. And so, now they're the British guy. Now they're clashing. So, it's hard to get a close-up because it's hard to put them back. So that's what that guy is like. I think the minifigures are pretty cool that we made. Then we've got this British soldier. Uses a woman's torso, but it's fine. Like, it works. If it works, then you should use it. So, this guy is supposed to be kind of leaning back. Because he's kind of getting beaten by that guy. And then move over, and we see the general, the American general. That's why he's wearing fancy clothes, because he is a commander. No, George Washington, but still. Here's his war horse. It's up on his hind legs, and he's got a, thing where you can put the sword in. You put the sword in that like satchel thing. So that's cool. And then we move along. I want to get to that at the end because it's the main thing in this mock. So then move over here. We see someone. He's lying down, and there's blood right there. So he was a French soldier. As you can see, he has the blue uniform and the straps. And then over here, that's a cannon blast. And then he's getting knocked away by it. Because he was in radius, so... There he goes. The two Americans down. Well, not that guy yet, but soon he will be. Then we've got, I'll show you them better. That's what he looks like. His face is not there, though. I just think I should show you the minifigures because they're really cool and they're custom. Using that, it's like an 18th century war. Listen, this is like that guy looks like late 17th, early 18th. And then there's this guy rushing towards him because my friend said he knew that guy. This guy knew that French guy. So he's rushing toward this guy to shoot him, and also because he's an enemy. So, yeah. Then, here's what he looks like. He's just got a revolver. So, probably, he's not armed well, but, I mean, probably gonna get that guy. That's why you don't kill people, because other people are gonna try to kill you. Not a real life lesson, but it's kind of wipey, I guess. Can make it win. So then, we got Ben Franklin over there, defending this outpost. And So, there's a little guardrail, and he's poking his musket through, to shoot him. And if we turn around, we see some rock structure, and a little chest with some things in it, and a little box. That's the supplies. So, this was my first mock. I hope you enjoyed. It's hard to show you everything, but actually, one last thing. I'm just going to show you Ben Franklin close up. Because I showed you all the other figures. And I'm very proud of this mock. I know it's not the probably not the coolest thing in the world or the best mock there is, but I don't do mocks a lot, and so I like this. I think it's a nice war scene. Tell me who you think will win in the comment section below, the Americans or the British. Not the war, but this battle. And we'll just see who wins, and I guess you could vote who you think will win. Might put together a few comments. The first 15 comments. Yeah, the first 15 comments will be the first 15 votes will be looked at. And we'll decide who wins the battle. See you guys next time. And peace out. Well, I guess not peace, because this isn't a very peaceful time, but still.